In the year 1298, at the age of 44, Marco was captured and thrown into a dungeon with a man named Rustichello, a writer of romantic fiction. One can imagine his stunned disbelief when Marco Polo began relating his adventures. Adventures that far exceeded any Rustichello could have concocted himself. For Marco was claiming that before coming back to Italy, he had spent nearly 20 years in China as a personal aide to the mighty Kublai Khan.
I assure you for a fact that before Monsieur Marco had been very long at court, he had mastered four languages and their writings. Observing his wisdom, the Khan sent him as an emissary to a country named Karajong, which it took him a good 6 months to reach.
Marco would have Rustichello believe that beginning at age 21, he served for the next 17 years as a special envoy for Kublai Khan, that he was his eyes and ears in the outreaches of China, Tibet, Burma, India, and even as far away as Java.
There is still some lingering controversy as to whether Marco Polo actually reached China. He mentions that he, his father, and his uncle were very important in a major battle that the Mongols undertook against the Song dynasty, against the Chinese. Unfortunately, the battle occurred 3 years before Marco Polo actually reached China, despite these errors and contradictions, because there is so much in the work that's accurate. My own feeling, as I say, is that there's no question that Marco Polo reached China.